After racist Raiders players break white quarterback's back, look what they're doing to fans in parking for standing. The state of the National Football League is a brutal reminder to many Americans what has become of national pride. What was once a standard dosage of appreciation for this country and its freedoms has become considered racist patriotism and anti-minority sentiments. Where we used to be able to at least be able to show our patriotism without fear of recompense, we're now harassed by those who consider the country itself racist and unfair. We've seen that in a huge way with the football players who took a stand by way of taking a knee. The players who consider themselves or those they identify with to be repressed have upped their game a couple of notches in recent weeks. They went from kneeling to Black Power salute to even intentionally causing harm even to players on their own team. Chrissy Holly of Freedom Daily reported on the horrifying incident that took place within the ranks of the Raiders. These players are turning on each other and showing the world that their loyalty to their race comes before any other promises made. Things took a startling turn for the worst at the beginning of the month after white Raiders quarterback Derek Carr had his back broken during a tackle where some sports commentators are speculating that Carr's all-black offensive line refused to block for him as a savage punishment for Carr for choosing to stand for the national anthem while they all sat before the game. Carr doing something that was once par for the course before every football game as recently as last year, now causing him to be targeted is appalling. Even if they have a disagreement with their quarterback, this is a far cry from the, quote, peaceful protest that the players are always claiming to participate in. As Carr's season-ending injury looks to be the result of a disgusting act of racism on the football field, we'd hope to see some sort of disciplinary action on the part of the NFL, but with the NFL now appearing to support these types of racist-inspired injuries, fans have finally had enough. Now the NFL just got a brutal taste of reality over the weekend as to what happens when they continue to ignore their fans in order to pander their racist and America-hating athletes. This is, of course, a difficult allegation to nail down. Not only is the league not interested in getting their hands dirty in a racially charged situation like this, but who can really say whether a player saw someone coming or if they just got distracted? The fans, however, think they know what's going on and they're not happy. New York Post reported on an altercation between the Raiders' left tackle and some really unhappy fans. The Pro Bowl left tackle of the Raiders entered into a shouting match with taunting fans in the Oakland parking lot after his team lost a 32-17 game to the Ravens on Sunday, dropping the Raiders to 2-3 as frustration builds, but the Giant never threw down. Penn, in his 11th year, exited his car as a group of fans heckled the apparent leader wearing a Raiders shirt. Penn, all 6'5" and 305 pounds of him, approached the fan and started screaming the only discernible words, "not flattering." It's a tough day for NFL players when they're being heckled by their own fans. It's not unusual for the fans of another team to bother a player that they think was unfair, but for the home team to be getting flack from someone wearing team merchandise, something has seriously upset the apple cart. "What are you gonna do, blank butt blank?" Penn screamed with nothing between the fans and the offensive tackle, but a small metal barricade and a few security guards. Penn never lost control and returned to his car. "He threw a bottle at my car, but I should have stayed in the car. He was trying to get me to react, so He could sue me. Glad I took a second to think, Penn tweeted Sunday night. Penn, who has been in Oakland since 2014 after seven seasons with Tampa, signed a two-year, $21 million deal last month, warning strong language. We are not going to put the sound on this, but you get the drift of this. You get the drift of this. You get it? You can see what's taking place. Because they don't allow it, you know? So it's automatically flagged, but you get the drift. They're actually confronting each other in the parking lot there. To say that the exchange was heated would be an understatement. Thankfully, there was security present and it didn't escalate any more than necessary, but it's unfortunate that the issue came up at all. Wow. This would have escalated had there not been somebody in the, wow. If you've been a loyal fan of the team for years and some of the players were even suspected of intentionally letting the quarterback be sacked because of his race or pride in his country, you'd probably be pretty mad too. And as a side note, what if a bunch of white players let a black quarterback be sacked? How would that go over? Apparently, it's not only racism when it's happening to someone who's a minority. Obviously, the Raiders fans don't agree. Well, it's sickening. That's all. They're a bunch of hoods. And that's basically the bottom line. It's disturbing to say the least. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And again, thank you so much for watching.